Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to take a look at how to convert an external format character to a CC4 skeleton, then use the Optimize and Decimate tool to make it less resource intensive for use in a wider variety of scenarios. AccuRIG not only converts any model to a CC4 skeleton, but also preserves the character's facial bones. The CC4 rig is optimized for use with iClone's motion library and collection of motion editing tools. We'll be using this Daz Genesis character as our sample model to demonstrate the workflow. As you can see, this process will still maintain the facial bones, so your character will still have complete facial animation capabilities. Let's start by importing our character. In this case, I'll just drag the FBX in from my Explorer window as a character and make sure that I choose Humanoid. CC will now auto-detect the Daz skeleton and do the bone mapping for you. Keep in mind that you can also import Daz characters with CC3 Plus specifications using the dedicated Transformer tool workflow. You can find a tutorial on this in our Reillusion courses page. It's now defined as a humanoid character, and you can open up the Bone Manager to see the number of bones and show them in your viewport. Naturally, you can also adjust the bone properties as well. Okay, next let's look at converting the skeleton. You'll find the AccuRIG button in the Attributes tab of the Modify panel. In AccuRIG mode, the first thing we want to do is click Create Guides, which will remove the existing bone definitions. You'll see two options, either to extrapolate the guides from the existing skeleton or generate a completely new one. In this case, since we already have a skeleton, let's choose the extrapolate option. You'll then see the familiar joint markers appear, and make sure you have the correct number of fingers selected. You'll also have another two options, to use the existing facial bones or generate new ones. Here we'll keep the existing ones. Once the skeleton is generated, click the Bind Skin button to generate the skin weights. Bone color change will indicate that the skin weight generation was a success, so now you can exit AccuRIG mode. You'll now see that the bone count in the Bone Manager has been reduced to 168, which consists of 101 CC4 bones and 67 Daz facial bones. Bone naming will be according to CC specifications, which makes it easy to retarget your character for use with other software. Okay, next let's check the animation results and apply our Daz facial profile. Test motions can be found in the animation player, and you can choose from a number of different options for various testing scenarios. Let's now move on to the facial profile editor, which can be found in the animation tab. We're going to create an expression system for our character, which again you can learn more about in the Reillusion course page. When we initially enter into Edit Expressions mode, none of the sliders will be defined. You can of course do this manually, but thankfully there is a Daz general profile which will save you time. You can find all of the Daz facial profiles under the following folder structure. This may differ slightly if you customized your installation folder path. Since our character is a G8 female, what I'll do here is simply click and drag the relevant profile to our character in the viewport. This will display the blend shapes available for this profile. If we return to Edit Expressions mode, you can see that basic bone definitions for head and eye movement have been defined, but only a few general blend shapes. The rest still need to be manually added, which can be done via the Batch Import feature and choosing the original FBX. We have a more detailed tutorial on this on our Reillusion courses page. Alright, now that we have our character imported and all set up, let's save it in the Content Manager. If we take a look at the file properties, we can see that it's 181 megabytes, which is okay for some uses, but if we want it to be part of a large crowd, for example, we definitely want to reduce that size. This is where the Optimize and Decimate feature comes in handy. If we click that button in the Attributes tab, we'll be presented with some preset LOD settings, but we can also customize our own as well. We cover the basics in another tutorial. There are four sections in custom LOD settings that can be adjusted: skeleton, mesh, texture, and facial. Since our character will really only have very basic animation that we can see from afar, we can deselect a lot of the bones that are used in more detailed up-close motions. We can also use the polygon reduction option to reduce the mesh in a variety of ways, In this case, I'm just choosing by percentage, which will take it down to 25% of the original geometry. I'll also define a lower max texture size, and since we already unchecked facial bones in the skeleton section, it will be disabled here. After we convert, we can see that the character has become much less detailed, particularly if we zoom in. Again, the amount of optimization you choose depends on how you're going to use your character in your final project. In this case, we only need to see our character animated from afar, so we don't need to be too concerned about detailed materials or geometry. If I save this character, then I can open up its properties and compare it to the original. You'll see that this process has optimized it down to 51 megabytes, which is huge if you plan on having a bunch more similar characters in your scene. Again, the level that you optimize your character to depends entirely on how you intend to use it. From afar, reduced geometry and materials are not a big deal and end up saving a lot of system resources for better performance. That's about it for this tutorial, guys. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.